Good evening and welcome to News Break. I'm Sanket Upadhyay. Breaking away from the news around the government farmer standoff and also the news of a standoff between the vaccine manufacturers, surprisingly, we are going to talk about something which is equally important: freedom of speech and expression. Now, this pertains to a comedian who was performing his gig in Madhya Pradesh, in Indore to be precise. And while he was doing so, some people, vigilante group members who were in attendance, entered, objected, and then brought in the police, got an FIR registered, and jailed this comedian along with three more people. Later, as it now appears, 2 days later, only today, the police in Indore says that we have gone through, reportedly they say, we have gone through the material provided to us and we don't seem to find anything objectionable. The comedian is still under arrest. While all of this is happening, whom is really that joke on? Think about it. There is a gag on the gig, comedians also not being spared. Will people speak up? What do comedians themselves feel? Satirists, what do they feel about this? We are going to put this through a discussion over the next 30 minutes. But first, let's take a look at what exactly happened in Indore, which led to this.
पहले तो मैं आप ये सोचते हो कि सिर्फ मैं हिंदू देवी दूत नहीं, मेरा सबसे पहले वीडियो में सबसे पहला जो टेररिज्म और इस्लाम पे, और सेकंड हर वीडियो में ट्रिपल तलाक पे जो
आपने अल्लाह के ऊपर
पैगंबर
साहब के ऊपर बनाया
क्या? सर, मेरी पूरी बात नहीं है, उसके बाद
सर जस्ट लेट हिम स्पीक यार।
अरे सर, मेरी बात तो सुनिए, मेरे को 10 मिनट दे दीजिए, मैं आपको बहुत बताइए। मैं जो कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा, मैं क्या करूँ? तहसीलदार है, ये आ रहा है घर पे गालियां, फोन नंबर लीक हो रहा है, कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा। सबसे बात कर रहा हूँ, बोल पर काम डाउन है, लॉकडाउन है, ये है वो है, कुछ समझ नहीं आ रहा, कुछ कर नहीं सकता। उसके बाद 8 दिन के बाद मैंने नॉर्मल से एक फोटो डाला जिसमें शायरी वायरी लिख के, और उसके 10 दिन के बाद मैंने एक वीडियो रिलीज किया, और उस वीडियो के रिलीज में शायर मिंडर, उस वीडियो के एंड में मैंने प्रॉपरली क्लेरिफिकेशन में डाला है कि मेरा काम मजाक उड़ाना किसी का है, मेरा लोगों को हंसाने का काम है। अगर मेरे जोक से किसी के धर्म को या किसी के आस्था को ठेस पहुंचती है तो मैं वो कभी नहीं चाहूंगा, मेरा काम है। और वो वीडियो 15 दिन बाद अपलोड मैंने किया है और आपने उसका एंड नहीं देखा होगा। तो मैंने फर्स्ट, इन्होंने जो कहा कि इसके लिए इन्होंने कभी माफी नहीं मांगी, तो उसके लिए आपको इसलिए बता रहा हूँ कि आप जाके वो वीडियो चेक कीजिए, उसके एंड में मैंने क्लेरिफिकेशन डाला है।
किसी को फर्क पड़ता है, मुझे फर्क पड़ता है। आप आज यहाँ वादा करिए कि इस तरह का कोई भी गंदा मजाक किसी के लिए नहीं करेंगे।
आप यहाँ
बिल्कुल
आपको ठेस नहीं पहुंचेगी, और सुनिए, मैं आपको ठेस नहीं पहुंचेगी। और दूसरी चीज मैं बताना चाहता हूँ आपको कि सबका फेथ अलग अलग होता है, सब इंसान होते हैं ना, उसका फेथ अलग अलग होता है। मेरे को पत्थर लगता है ना तो मैं
ऐसे बैठा,
मेरी बहन को पत्थर लगता है तो गिर जाती,
मेरा भी फेथ अलग
है, सबका फेथ अलग है।
आप मेरे लिए
वही बोल रहा हूँ, वही बोल रहा हूँ की मैं ये नहीं बोल रहा
हूँ अच्छा शो कैंसिल करने की बात कर रहे हो ना।
सर, आप बहुत इज्जत और बहुत आबरू के साथ आए इंटरनेट पे, आज कोई भी इंसान लोग आप बहुत इज्जत से आपकी आस्था मुझे ठेस लगी है ना, वो सच में लगी है। इंटरनेट पे जो गाली देते ना उनको ठेस नहीं लगी है, वो फ्रस्ट्रेटेड है कि भाई लड़कियों के साथ घूम रहा है, बड़ी अच्छी लाइफ जी रहा है इंटरनेट पे। आज कम्युनिटी में
So all of this happened on a Friday. This video that you see right now is from Indore, where a comedian, Munawwar Farooqi, a stand-up comedian from Gujarat, was performing his gig. And then a person who claims to be a member of an organization that stands up for the rights of Hindus. And also, interestingly, Eklavya Singh Gaur, the man you saw who was objecting to this gig, he's the son of a local BJP legislator, Malini Lakshman Singh Gaur. He filed a police complaint. Let's put this through a discussion very quickly. I've got Anubhav Pal, playwright, screenwriter, novelist and comedian with me. We have Akash Banerjee, a political satirist with us. We also have Mr. Abhishek Tripathi, he's a BJP supporter, filmmaker, writer, and a columnist. And we have Karuna Nandi, advocate in the Supreme Court. Thank you very much. This is a very, very important discussion. Because let's begin with you, Anubhav. Who is this person, Eklavya Singh Gaur? I have a very interesting designation for him also. I like to call him the self-appointed president of BCCI, the Board of Control for Comedy in India, where he says, and I quote, after purchasing the tickets, my associates and I, look at the language, my associates and I went to the comedy show where Faruqi was performing as the main comedian. Objectionable talks were going on during the comedy show. We made a video of them and stopped the show by taking the audience out of the cafe. Then we caught the comedians. We caught the comedians and organizers of the show and took them to the police station. Anubhav, what comes to your mind when you listen to this?
You know, one thing I promised myself, Saket, in 2021, and you have some great satirists on this panel. I've known Abhishek a long time. I've decided that I'm going to look for humor in even the most depressing things. So my first point is, given the state of the country, I'm surprised that this doesn't happen more often by any group that's offended. You know, 3 or 4 years ago, there was in Pune, there was an incident with a comedian where a comedian was offended by what was being said about DJs who mix music. And then they threatened to beat up the comedian. The first thing that most people think is that it's a powerful political party that wants to exert its control. But I have a feeling now there is a certain thing in the atmosphere that anyone can beat up anyone who they think has objectionable material. The other thing that I'm very amused by, Saket, is the charge. And Karuna might be able to help me on this.
Yeah.
The comedian has been charged. One of the many charges is IPC 269. Can I read out IPC 269?
Yeah.
It's whoever unlawfully or negligently does any act which is, and which he knows or has reason to believe is, likely to spread the infection of any disease dangerous to life.
Yes. Correct.
Now, I know laughter is infectious, Sanket. I know it's infectious. But this is also one of the charges he has been leveled with. Having been doing this, Sanket, last point I want to make is for about 10 years, I have come to the conclusion that, now this is getting a lot of press, but the number of times comedians have been heckled, beaten up, show stopped, has been exponentially increasing over the last 5 or 7 years.
Yeah.
I am not saying it's because of a certain political climate that is for observers and experts such as you that observe the country to find out. But I am seeing people being told, I don't like this show. It is objectionable to me personally, my politics, shut up, leave. You cannot leave this town, etc.
So that this is just an extension. You feel that this is just an extension of what has been happening.
I'm surprised that more such things are not happening.
Okay.
Because interesting. It's getting everywhere. And the feeling I'm getting, last thing I want to say, at these shows, is it's becoming like an Air India flight that's delayed. It's a group of people that descend on the comedian and say, who is your duty manager? It's like that. Like, we are supposed to take the responsibility for everyone else's objection. And then we don't know what to do, so we end up in jail.
This is the beauty of talking to a comedian, because he can find comic even in the most tragic of situations. But Akash Banerjee, yes, Akash, see, the point is, you look at what this self-appointed president of Board of Control for Comedy in India has said, and juxtapose it with what the Indore police today has told the Indian Express. The Indore police says, and I am quoting, there is no evidence against him for insulting Hindu deities or Union Minister Amit Shah. The two videos submitted by the complainant are of another comedian with him allegedly cracking jokes. Unquote.
So, let's get one thing very clear. First and foremost, don't be surprised if this whole thing is turned back and another police statement comes out and says, nahi, hua tha, because that is what is being claimed. Now reports are saying, no, the police has been misquoted. The second thing is, Sanket, even if that is the case, the message has gone out loud and clear that, listen, do not even try doing this. Okay. So let's you know, get some base rules absolutely right. Now Anubhav might be sitting and joking about it because I don't think he's sitting in India. Pehle to mujhe lag raha hai he's sitting somewhere outside, because otherwise he wouldn't have found the situation so funny maybe.
Mr.
Banerjee, so let's get this whole thing out.
Anubhav is very much in India, Akash.
He's a brave man then. Then he's a brave man. So let's get this notion out that you can have comedy in India that even mentions the name of a god. Was something said or not, Sanket? We can have this debate for half an hour and people will still not be convinced. And let's not forget, there is a bigger problem. How many people have faced the flak, have faced abuses for joking about politicians? We are living in a country where you can't joke about politicians. You're talking about comedy of any other sort involving even a name. So maybe there was a little bit of innocence on part of Bunapur to have even tried something like this. This is the harsh truth that we are living in. BCCI will decide what you and I can joke on. That's the truth.
Okay. Ms. Nandi, before I go to Mr. Tripathi, but Ms. Nandi, I want to come to you. The legal action that has been initiated. Now, I do know that Section 269, which is Unlawful and Negligent Act Likely to Spread the Infection, has to do with allegations of not following COVID protocol. That was one of the charges that have been pressed against the comedian. But the manner in which it has been done, and it is continuing to happen, do you feel that it was about time that something like this would happen? That the joke is actually on us?
You know, Sanket, the joke is completely on us. The fact that we have tolerated these laws and the unequal application and the police basically going with whoever seems to be in power, the joke is very much on us. Of course, the 269 allegation is absolutely ridiculous, because while the winter session of parliament has been shut down, we see the prime minister as well as the home minister, about whom apparently allegedly jokes were made, you know, having all sorts of huge public meetings in which none of these safety protocols are followed. So that, of course, is blatantly ridiculous. But with regard to the blasphemy law, I think that the very existence of the blasphemy law is something that is not challenged enough. For, you know, you saw the video was very interesting, because what the Hindutva fellow had come, you know, the member of the BCCI, as you were calling him, what that fellow was saying was that, look, just because you make jokes about your own religion doesn't mean you're entitled to make jokes about mine. And I don't want to make jokes about yours, you see. So what he was saying was that, look, we're going to privilege religion over, and not talking about religion and not making jokes about religion, over any kind of discourse. And of course, this is a problem, because not only does it privilege religious orthodoxies then, right? So for example, if somebody wants to, there's so many versions of the Ramayana, or if somebody wants to make a feminist critique of the Ramayana, of which there are many, from within the religion. See, a religious Hindu wants to make a feminist critique of the Ramayana.
Even that could be treated as blasphemy.
That could easily be treated as blasphemy. Part of the problem, of course, so you're privileging religious orthodoxies, which means that you're privileging patriarchal, hidebound, people right at the very top of the religious orthodoxies, also people at the very top of the political religious orthodoxies now in particular. And I think that's a huge problem. Also, just look at the conduct of this fellow, is whoever he is, but look at the conduct of the police. Today, they say that there was nothing objectionable in the video, but how dare they arrest someone without looking at the video and deciding whether there was any content or not. And secondly, why would you arrest someone just because it's a cognizable offense? Because the law is very clear. Just because you can arrest someone doesn't mean you do arrest someone. And so the person who should have been arrested is the person who purported to arrest this comedian for willful imprisonment, you know, for confining him in a particular spot.
To create a situation where there is vigilante justice. Now, Mr. Tripathi, you've heard the comments of the advocate, you've heard the comment of the satirist, the comedian. Now I come to you. Don't you think that this is not funny? I mean, how can you justify what has happened in Madhya Pradesh? And today it's Madhya Pradesh, tomorrow it could be anyone. I mean, a comedian is just an extension of a circumstance or a situation that journalists are facing, cartoonists are facing. What next? Sedition?
Okay, let me start from the very fact that why is it that happening that people are picking up religion only for comedy? Are they running out of the real comedy ideas? Since our childhood, hear me out, since my childhood, and we all have seen Johnny Lever doing comedy, Raju Srivastava doing comedy, we have seen so many comedians that we have grown up on, we have never seen them doing all of this. Why is it that happening in last 5 years only?
No, Mr. Tripathi, this is exactly why I started by saying that are you in a good mood to propose a board for control of comedy in India?
Where no, no, it's not about that. Is anybody advocating and are trying to support people and so-called comedian
who
are living out
the laws of
on the basis of joke, cracking on a certain religion? Do you want to support that? And time and again it is happening. It's happening in last 3-4 years like n number of times. And why is this happening? There's so many content. There's so many genuine, satire thing that you can pick up from the society. You can always do it on politics.
I'm not going to indulge in whataboutery.
But you are picking up, religion.
Very, very limited point that I'm trying to make. A factual point that I'm trying to make, because this debate is not a joke. Mr. Tripathi, the point is that there was an allegation against this comedian to which reportedly now the Indore police itself is saying, we do not have proof.
I have heard that it could not be true. It could be somebody else, but there is always someone who's doing it.
So you will jail anyone.
This probably.
Someone somewhere is doing something which is somewhat wrong, so jail someone.
No. Let's see. They know the prima facie what is happening. On the spot, whatever the law and order could do, they are doing it. But let's not talk about just the Madhya Pradesh police because there is a BJP government there. Let's talk about Maharashtra and police, what they have done in recent times, we all know. But we are not here to discuss. We should talk about the very fact that why is this happening since many years that you are so easily picking up the characters that we pray, the religion that we pray on. Why is it that it can't a comedy? We all like it. The gentleman, the fellow, my panelist, respected. He's sitting. I've seen him performing. I've never seen him doing something like that. Why is somebody else doing it to learn any?
I need a comment from the one moment, Anubhav as well as Akash, one by one. Please go one by one. Anubhav, to you first. How do you respond to this?
Well, two things. One is that. So I don't know if he was talking about whether he's seen me perform. I haven't done anything about religion because I'm not a very religious person and I'm terrified to talk about religion. And I feel people have a right to their faith. Hmm. But my larger question is...
But people are scared. I think that's a very important point.
Yeah, terrified. Yeah. But the larger point is that there is actually no set of guidelines that decides, like for example, plays and films. There are guidelines, there's a censor board. I'm saying that will Jungle Raj decide every comedy show? I mean, that's my only question. I respect the gentleman's right to be offended by religion, but he's offended by religion. Tomorrow someone can be offended by elephants. I know a comedian who was nearly beaten up for talking about vegetarians. So I'm saying who controls what is offensive? Hmm. That is
imagine, Anubhav, when you did that gig for the BBC in London in 2019, and you called Britishers to their face. You called them treacherous.
Yes.
You had the chance of being beaten up. I mean, you were clearly in minority.
Luckily, the audience were older, so they were, I was a little younger, so I got away. But I guess the point the gentleman is raising is very valid. He is offended by religion as a topic. He has absolute right in a democracy to be offended. But if a comedian... What does a comedian... Say a comedian wants to choose a range of topics. Which are safe topics?
Yeah.
The gentleman might say these are 5 safe topics. They're safe for him. What about another 130 crore people?
Okay. Akash Banerjee. See, the point is, Akash, right now, someone somewhere is hurting religious sentiments. First of all, where do you stand on this issue? Do you steer clear from debates around or discussion or satire around religion? Because, you know, when your satire is political satire. And I don't think you can really... dehyphenate this discourse.
So I find this
this debate a little sad also is because we are talking about debating about religion where you can't even have a small get up or put one tikka before people come with you with hammer and swords. We are living in an era where, Sanket, tomorrow somebody might not like you and come into the studio and drag you to the police
Why
station.
Me?
Because that's a fear harmless. That I live with, that there might be a knock on my door and the morning walk jokes. Which is not a joke anymore. Mm. These are facts that are happening. And Sanket, you see, you have to understand how it's going downhill. Earlier, it used to be a Salman Rushdie writing a inflammatory book, a Taslima Nasreen, or M.F. Hussein painting something in the nude. Now it has come down to stick figures going to the Supreme Court for contempt. One chuttu young comedian marrowing a comment which is endangering the sentiments of millions of people. And that slide, unfortunately, is very, very dangerous, is when people just take things into their own hands, what is happening. I'm sad to say I feel ashamed of my proud country and my proud heritage because we used to laugh when this used to happen in Pakistan.
No, Akash, I think you're doing all of this because you want Z plus security.
That's not going to happen because then I'll have to call out Bollywood. So that won't happen.
Very quickly, Mr. Tripathi and then Ms. Nandi. Mr. Tripathi, I hope you've got your answer. My point is, at what point will you stop? At what point will you stop justifying? Can you not, as a creative person, you may be politically affiliated, but as a creative person, respect creative pursuit?
We all watch so many comedy shows on different channels. We all laugh. We all love it. I know all of them personally, being part of the industry. Very, very close to me. There is no offense in all of that. There's so many comedy which is happening all over. There's so many stage shows which is happening all over. Why this few set of people, very few set of, I'm not saying, and let's not label the entire comedies at attack. No, that's not true. Hmm. Only few certain people are trying to be the B team and the C team and the E team and the D team. Let's not create that atmosphere that we need a religion.
You
religion
get
to
something
crack a
specific.
Joke.
Because Mr. Tripathi, you're talking about
you have to
someone
crack a joke
somewhere,
on religion for you
something...
to be a comedian on stage and on money. I don't think there's a lot of, like I gave the example, we have grown up watching some great comedians on stage. We are still watching it on television and on possibly
Mr.
in all
Tripathi,
channels.
I respect that even comedians must know their boundary. There are certain things that you can joke of, and then there are certain things that you cannot joke about, right? I'm sure comedians and political satirists are aware. This is a battle they fight every day. I'm sure they do.
Nobody here is wrong in the panel, but understand the point where we are living, how we are living, and it is very important to respect this kind of sentiment.
Now, what if someone were to turn this around and tell this to you? Just replay your statement back to yourself.
Yes, exactly. I will not hold back my words, and you know that. I am saying that. Openly, sure. I am saying that. Ms. It is Nandi, very important to understand the sentiments of the people when you are doing
Ms.
any
Nandi,
kind of
legally,
work.
Very, very, very quickly, I believe I have also been told that a very special guest who is watching this discussion, this debate, wants to participate in this debate, Ms. Usha Uthup. She is going to join us in just a short moment. She really wants to participate in this discussion. But very quickly, Ms. Nandi, the legal options available for this comedian.
The comedian could immediately go for quashing and say that nothing that could at all come in the ambit of section 295A has been said. But I don't think that would really meet the problem here. What Mr. Tripathi is saying is something that a lot of people believe, and you yourself said, Sanket, that comedians should know boundaries. What boundaries? Why have we come to a point in this polity where the politicians talk about religion all the time and the religious leaders talk about religion all the time and tell us what to think? And the comedians who are now the sharpest and the bravest political, comedians are the sharpest and the bravest political satire in this country.
Many would argue best journalists.
Why? Let us think of this.
Yeah, no, I get your point, but Ms. Nandi, just to clarify, because you quoted me, my point over here is just taking from where Anubhav left, that you have guidelines, you've got a code of conduct for all of us. Similarly, for a satirist in this creative pursuit to know exactly what he's doing or you feel that it should be absolutely free?
No, Sanket. I think that
because you know, I will also not.
Not an absolute right, right?
I'm sure a lot of people.
One of my favorite comedians, I find him hilarious. Anubhav is scared. Sure. He said so himself. There's a huge chilling effect because of which a large number of comedians in our country do not go near religion. Our top comedians, many of them, do not go near religion, right? Yes.
So you're saying that this is a fear built in deliberately.
You are insulting the dignity of an individual as opposed to an idea.
They don't, then go, that is something they don't go close to many other things also, not only religion.
Like what? Akash, like what?
They want their morning walks. Those people who want their morning walks, the people who respect long beards. So let's not kid ourselves. This is not about religion. This is only a start of a long, solid slope. Today it is religion. And by the way, look at the headlines and look at the statement that was made immediately after, saying the comments were made against the Home Minister.
Yeah.
Do you think that people are not censoring themselves about the politicians? Do you think Mr. Tripathi is going to laugh at a joke on the Home Minister or the Prime Minister? I would love to see that happen.
Okay. Okay. Usha Uthup, I believe, is now on the phone line with us. Yes, Ms. Uthup. Oh, you're live. Good evening. How are you? I believe you wanted to be a part of this discussion. Yes, ma'am. Eager to hear you.
Yes, in fact, I wanted to be on this discussion so much, you know, because all of you are talking about comedians and religion and whatnot. You know, me as a bichara singer in a sari and covered from head to toe all the time, in 1983, I was banned, can you believe it, by the PWD minister at that time. His name was Jatin Chakravarti. And can you believe it, I was actually banned from singing in any government-held auditorium. And the song was Koi Yaha Aha Nache Nache. Now, what's that got to do with religion or anything at all? I mean, this is what I cannot understand. Why are we making such a big hue and cry about this, whether it is on religion or in... Don't people have a sense of humor? I mean, they actually banned me from performing. And then, of course, I took them to court. And it was Subrata Roy Chaudhary who fought my case. And, you know, they said that I was decadent. My culture, I mean, my music was decadent to the culture of Bengal. And everybody, of course, even Jyoti Babu stood by me, and everybody stood by me. The media stood by me. And I won the case. I mean, it was a writ petition against fundamental rights. And I won the thing.
I think this is interesting perspective. So this means that this long downward slope that Akash is talking about did not begin only now. It's been in existence for a very long time.
Forever. And it started with my singing Koi Yaha Aha Nache Nache, where they took one individual, I mean, just me, and banned me. I mean, for what? It's my fundamental right to sing it. If you've got some rubbish in your mind and you're thinking of something else, that's
how do you blame the the artist for it? Okay.
And
how
do you blame the people at large?
Absolutely.
I mean, how do you do that? And how can you blame somebody?
I've unfortunately run out of time, but thank you so much. It was great to have you on the show. But Anubhav, Akash, Ms. Nandi, Ms. Usha Uthup, as well as Mr. Tripathi, thank you so much. Let us hope that some comedy definitely exists in all our lives. Otherwise, it'll be really boring, won't it?